Good evening. Tonight, Tennessee House Speaker Glen Casada's office confirms the authenticity of text messages in which his chief of staff brags about his use of illegal drugs.
Included is a text where Cade Cothran brags about snorting cocaine inside his legislative office. And now we've also uncovered other texts where both men speak of women in vulgar terms.
Now, all of this comes days after News Channel 5 uncovered racist text messages from the chief of staff. Our chief investigative reporter, Phil Williams, has another News Channel 5 Investigates exclusive. Phil.
Well, guys, the latest text messages were sent back in 2015 and 2016 when Cade Cothran was press secretary for the Tennessee House Republican caucus. They're part of the same batch of text messages from a former acquaintance that the House Speaker last week has suggested were bogus.
The motion to reconsider is tabled.
On Thursday, it was business as usual on the floor of the Tennessee House of Representatives, just hours after News Channel 5 Investigates revealed the existence of racist text messages sent by the House Speaker's chief of staff, Cade Cothran.
My chief of staff is up here. He's up here working. He did nothing wrong.
Among Cothran's text messages, there was this 2015 text, "Black people are idiots." In another, he insisted on using thug N-word to describe Tampa Bay quarterback Jameis Winston. And in a 2016 exchange with Casada himself, Cothran responded with this black people meme, apparently referring to a West Tennessee district. The House Speaker claimed he never got such a text.
Again, it kind of verifies in my mind there's something not right about that story.
It was a theme Casada continued on talk radio.
In this environment that we live in, because we as conservatives are winning the intellectual battle, I'm convinced some liberal guy living with his mom and dad in their basement created this to frame my chief of staff.
But the text messages also included this selfie that Cothran had taken at 2:15 a.m. during a trip to Colorado. He texted, "Tripping balls out of my mind at 2:15. Craziest experience of my entire life. Acid, cocaine, weed." He also shared this video from a concert at the Red Rocks Amphitheater and this wild scene from a party bus. After a 2015 trip to the Dominican Republic, Cothran also texted, "Just did a gram of cocaine in my office." It was sent at 10:38 a.m. on a work day.
You refer to Jameis Winston as a thug. How can you justify that?
After ignoring our previous questions about his racist text messages, Cothran responded this time with a written statement. "Regarding the text in question, I readily admit that I sent some of them. While I'm not proud of who I was in the past, I am proud that with God's grace and a strong support system, I've been able to achieve so much in the years since."
Without objection, so ordered. Next order, Mr. Clerk.
Casada himself had backed legislation in 2014 cutting off welfare recipients who tested positive for drugs. But in the case of Cothran, who makes $200,000 a year, the House Speaker was more lenient. Politics has become a game of gotcha with no thought of forgiveness and starting anew. I choose to believe that we all deserve a shot at redemption.
Do you think that black people are idiots?
But it wasn't just comments about minorities. We also obtained other text messages in which Cothran solicited sexual favors from legislative interns and suggested sex with a female lobbyist who was older than him. "I want you to be my first older woman," he texted. In one case in 2016, Cothran texted this pic of a female friend pole dancing to Casada. The House Speaker responded, "Nice pics. Cothran, hands to yourself. The Speaker, can I just touch? Cothran, LOL, okay, maybe just once. The Speaker, LOL."
Of course, this follows a legislative session in which Casada repeatedly dodged questions about allegations that a member of his own party had sexually assaulted three teenage girls years ago. Now, after the Speaker accused us of airing fabricated text messages, Cade Cothran suddenly says he cannot remember whether he sent them or not. As for the drug use, the legislature's Black Caucus is now calling for the TBI to investigate.